Yes. So the first question is, what do you think has been main reasons for the mob taking law in their hands? Why are the cases of mob justice increasing day by day? What are the reasons of mob justice increasing day by day?
Well, to some extent,
yes,
as you have said,
yes,
there is distrust,
yes,
particularly in the police,
yes,
that they will tackle and get booked,
yes,
the people who have committed a crime.
Yes.
So that is one.
Yes.
Because mob justice takes place when some incident takes part,
yes,
or somebody loses his life.
Yes.
So in that case, people want that person who is responsible for that loss of life to be punished quickly.
Yes.
And since the system in a rule of law is a rather complex, complicated, time consuming, so people, and many times by delays, the people get acquitted by corruption in the police also, inefficiency in the police also, people get acquitted. So people lose faith in the administration of justice. And therefore they want to, when they feel that this man has committed a crime, he should be punished. We don't know whether the system will have him punished or not, so let us inflict the punishment. That is mob justice. And mob justice, unless it is controlled by a strong hand and also education. So, because most of the lumpen elements join the mob, and since they have no job, no security, oh, they are happy, all right, somebody.
Yes.
So that's also some kind of motivation. So firstly, it has to be tackled with a strong hand whenever it happens. Secondly, steps must be taken to quicken the wheels of justice, and also that those who have committed a crime, the investigation should be more efficient, more scientific, more efficient.
And do you think that the huge delay done by the judiciary, yes, in pronouncing that judgments is origin?
That is also one of the factors.
We see sometimes a state itself or any state agency like police, like we see in the Patiala House Court case, encourages mob to take law in hands. Like the police stood as a mute spectator in Patiala House Court case. So, how do you see it when the state itself encourages mob to take law in hands?
This police normally,
yes,
would not activate the mob to do justice unless there is some political direction to it, under whose control the police is working.
Yes.
Unless there is a hint,
yes,
all right, in this matter, you allow the mob
to take law in hands. Do you think that the government is really serious about bringing a check on the phenomenon of mob justice? Do you think that the government is really serious about bringing a check on the phenomenon of mob justice?
Well, I don't feel that they could be non-serious, but probably they have not thought about in detail, or maybe that there is not enough intelligence among the leaders in the government to think deeply about these problems and to try to find out some solution.
If blame is to imposed chronologically for the increasing cases of mob justice, whom will you blame first? Mob itself, inefficient administration, right, or inefficient judiciary?
Mob itself.
And the last question is, lynching
and at the same time,
yes,
it should be realized कि when mob justice takes place, there is a lot of looting of property also.
Yes. Yes.
And therefore that provides an incentive to the limpet elements to be able to get away with lot of theft of valuable articles in some shops and so on.
It happens recently, it happened in Haryana. Yeah. Lots of public property as well as private property were looted out.
There it seems
yes.
that some political leaders were behind it.
Yes. And one more question is, lynching had once become so rampant in United States. Lynching had once become so rampant in United States.
Rampant?
Yes, rampant, rampant.
Huh?
Lynching, rampant, pervasive in United States.
Huh.
That one of the noted American author Mark Twain had sarcastically noted. Mark Twain.
Huh?
Mark Twain author Mark Twain had said.
Mark Twain.
Yes, yes. He said that United States had become, America has become United States of lynchardom.
Of lynch?
Lynchardom. So do you think that the similar situation is coming in India?
Well, to some extent, yes.
Yes.
But still, the general public does not like this lynch mentality. So, it, in my opinion, it can be controlled. And one way to control it is to quickly get the army to intervene. There should be no delay in calling the army when the police is unable to control. Or the police should be able to, should be told to stop it in the middle. Stop it straight away. Let it not grow. Nip it in the bud